Matthew 28, 19 and 20 says, "Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." This is an intimidating scripture. Who am I to make disciples and teach others to obey God's commands when I don't always get it right? But Jesus himself spoke these words, so how can they be ignored? A few years ago, my daughter wanted to go on a mission trip to Honduras. I didn't want her going without a parent, so I reluctantly said I would go also. Even then, because of my doubts and fears, I almost backed out at the last minute. I know I'm not the only one with these feelings and thoughts. We find so many reasons not to go. Family and job responsibilities, physical disability, financial need, fear of the unknown, safety issues, sins that make us feel unworthy, and lack of spiritual knowledge. On the Sunday that I intended to back out, the sermon was entitled, "When God Prepares," and I was reminded that God chooses the weak, the unlikely, and the unexpected to achieve his purposes and make his glory evident. The Bible is filled with people called out of their comfort zone to do the unexpected. Saul, a persecutor of Christians. Rahab, a prostitute. Jesus' mother Mary, a young girl from a nowhere town. And David, a simple shepherd boy. God used their individual abilities for purposes they could not have imagined. Like a garden filled with many varieties of flowers, God gives us different abilities, and we can be assured that each is important. 1 Corinthians 12, 4 through 6 says, "There are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but the same God works all of them in all men. We don't need to feel inadequate because we lack certain spiritual gifts. God will use what we have been given. Going to the nations begins by saying yes to something beyond yourself. It may be saying yes to the essential support of prayer or financial support. It may be saying yes to service within your own community or country. It may be saying yes to traveling to other countries on a short-term mission trip or joining another culture long-term. However you say yes, God will take what you bring and multiply it for his glory. You will be blessed, sharing a glimpse into God's global presence. God used my yes, fearfully and perhaps grudgingly given, to an amazing result. One reluctant trip to Honduras led to a second trip, where I was asked to help with decorations for an outreach event. And that led to four more trips where God has used my non-spiritual skills to design decor for women's conferences, where women have been led to Christ and deeper relationships with God. I have grown in my own faith, built lasting friendships, and been filled with joy to use my skills to contribute to a mission trip. That "When God Prepares" sermon challenged me to stop putting God in a box of human limitations, because an unboxed God can use anyone for anything at any time. I could not have imagined my mission trip story, but because I said yes, God filled the pages. How about you? Is your Go to the Nations story still waiting to be written? Yes is a powerful word to begin the first sentence. Father God, thank you for your unending love that continues to reach out for each one of us on this earth. Thank you for the blessing of talents and abilities. Help us to be wise stewards of these gifts and to be willing to use them for your purposes. May your glory be made evident in all that we do. Amen.